Hello everyone, Nimisha here from English Firm. Today we'll be discussing about one of the enabling skills in PTE called pronunciation. This is one of the most important factors which directly determine your speaking score. And I've seen many students struggle to get their speaking score just because of this factor alone, pronunciation, because your speaking is decided based on your fluency, pronunciation, and content. All three are equally important. So even if you have really good scores in fluency, if your pronunciation score is low, it could affect your speaking score. Vice versa as well. Even if your pronunciation score is really good, if your fluency is low, it'll still affect your speaking module. So pronunciation is one of the very important factors which can determine your speaking score. And I've seen many students struggle with this, even though their fluency is good, because of low scores in pronunciation, they're missing out their overall speaking score. So today we'll be discussing about the most common mistakes that students make, which actually reduce their pronunciation score and how to improve that. Okay, so let's start with it. So the first factor that you need to consider when you go to the exam is how to position your mic, because you need to understand that PTE is a completely computerized exam. There is no human involvement in it, even during the exam or even during the evaluation. So you need to remember that you're talking to a machine, you're talking to a computer. So if the computer does not hear you clearly, of course, it cannot evaluate you clearly as well. So one of the main reasons why many students lose points in pronunciation is because of wrong positioning of the mic. So in PTE, the mic that they use in the exam centers are very sensitive. So many people have a misunderstanding that if you keep it very close to your mouth, it will record clearly. This is a wrong idea, because since the microphone is very sensitive, if you keep it too close to your mouth, especially below your nose and right in front of your mouth, since it is very sensitive, it will record all the breathing noises that you're making, which actually distorts your pronunciation. So do not keep it too close to your mouth or right below your nose to avoid the breathing noises. You can either keep it right below your lips, right in front of your chin, two fingers apart, right in front of your chin. Do not keep it too close to your mouth. Do not keep it right below your nose to avoid the breathing noises. Okay, and in the exam, you get a chance to do that as well. Before you start the exam, you have a chance to record yourself, hear it back, and make sure that your voice is getting recorded clearly. You can do that task a couple of times to make sure that your mic is recording very clearly. Make sure that your voice is clear without too much of breathing noises, right? Now, the second factor is you need to speak loudly and clearly. You should not be mumbling. This is very common among students. Even though you're saying a very correct answer, your answer is very accurate, but if you mumble, if you do not open up and speak clearly, of course the computer would not understand you. Many people have a tendency of keeping their mouth half closed and they're speaking inside, but the words are not coming out clearly. So you should keep your voice very clear and loud, because again, you need to remember you're talking to a machine, not to a human being. So you need to be extra clear than you normally do, than you normally speak. Open up your mouth, speak clearly, do not mumble, and do not speak in a very low voice. This is something that I see, especially among girls. We tend to speak in a very low voice and the computer would not hear you. So speak up, speak loudly and clearly. That doesn't mean you have to shout. Speak relatively in a louder voice and clearer voice, and especially very confidently. Even if you're saying a wrong answer, speak very confidently so that the computer can record you accurately. Do not mumble. And the next factor that you see here, do not copy any accent, speak in your natural accent. This is another common error that I see among students, because you think that copying a native speaker's accent is going to improve your pronunciation, which is again, not a good idea, because you need to understand that PT is an exam. It's a computerized exam, computer evaluated exam, which is designed to evaluate English skills of non-native speakers. Non-native speakers means speakers of English whose first language is not English. So every non-native speaker, almost 80 to 90% of non-native English speakers will have a natural accent of their mother tongue, which is perfectly fine in PTE. The computer will still understand you even if you have your own native accent. You don't have to speak like a native English speaker. So you can if you want to, but if you try to do that, it'll be too much extra pressure on you and you might make more mistakes trying to do that. So speak in your natural accent, no need to copy any accent, no need to imitate any native English speaker. even though you have an accent, if you speak loudly and clearly, the computer will still understand you. So even when I'm speaking, I have an accent, which still did not matter when I took the exam. I still have 90, even though I have a native accent of my own. So your accent is not an issue in PTE. You don't have to copy or imitate anyone. You speak in your natural accent, but speak clearly. Now, the next factor that you see is one of the very important factors which can boost your pronunciation score a lot. In the first task of your speaking, read aloud, where you have a text on the screen and you have to read it out loud, make sure you read all the words accurately. So the common mistakes that I see here is when it is written reviews on the screen, people tend to read only review. So missing S, missing ED, missing ING, missing to, A, and the. So missing small words or changing the words from the question or adding extra words will directly affect your pronunciation, which also impacts your overall speaking score as well as your content score. And this directly affects your reading module as well. So try to read the words accurately and read aloud. This is mostly important for your content part, but of course it helps in your pronunciation too. So make sure you read the words accurately without changing any of them. This also boosts your pronunciation and mainly the content part of your speaking. Now, the next factor that you see, practice speaking with background noise. Might sound silly, but this is how you're supposed to do, because in PT exam centers, you're not going to be alone in a room. There will be 6 to 7 people with you who will be taking the exam at the same time. So all of you will be speaking at the same time. So it is going to be really noisy. People will be speaking behind you at the same time. So if you speak in a really low voice and if the people around you are louder than you, of course the computer will record those voices as well, which is the reason why you need to speak a bit more louder than you normally do. And to get used to that situation, when you practice by yourself at home too, do not go sit in a quiet room. Go to some place where there is noise. If you have nowhere else to go, at least put on the TV in front of you or just around. Put on the TV, put some interview on the TV so that there will be a background noise going on, and then sit with your laptop and headphones and practice, because you need to get used to a noisy scenario, because the exam center is also going to be noisy. So if you practice in a very quiet room and then you go to the exam and then it gets noisy, you won't be able to focus well. So when you practice speaking by yourself as well, practice with some background noise so you'll be able to concentrate well during the real exam as well. Okay, so these are few points which can help you to boost your pronunciation score. So mainly speak clearly, speak loudly, keep the mic positioning below your lips, not below your chin, in between your lips and chin, right in front of your chin, 2 fingers apart, not too close to your mouth, not too close to your nose, and speak loudly, speak clearly, do not mumble, no need to copy any accent, speak naturally, and make sure you read all the words accurately in your read aloud, and when you practice, practice with some background noise. All right, so that's pretty much it for today's topic for pronunciation. So I hope this helps you out. So if you have any doubts or questions, or if you have any feedback or reviews, or if you need us to do any more videos, any particular topic that you need to cover, let us know in the comment box. And if you need any help in PT preparation, you can reach us on 0432-269-874. Thank you.